Welcome to the viewers for the lecture in the subject structural analysis. In the last two lectures, 102 and 103, we have been discussing about strain energy method. In lecture number 102, we have discussed the basic concepts, Castiglione's theorem, and use in finding out the or analyzing the continuous beams, portal frames, and roof trusses. Right. In lecture number 103, last lecture, we have discussed about analysis of a two-span continuous beam by strain energy method. Right. Now, in this lecture, we will take up a frame for the analysis. Now, the problem is analyze the frame shown in figure by the strain energy method and sketch the bending moment diagram. Right. Now, this is the frame to be analyzed. So, this is the frame ABC. AB is of length 4 meters, BC is of length 6 meters. AB is subjected to a UDL of 40 kN per meter, and BC there is a lateral force at its mid height whose value is equal to 60 kN. Now, it is a statically indeterminate frame. Now, first we have to find out the degree of static indeterminacy, release number of reaction components is equal to the degree of redundancy, make the structure as a primary structure, introduce the redundancy as forces, and then we have to carry out the analysis. Right. Now, the degree of redundancy I equal to static indeterminacy I equal to number of closed loops into 3 minus number of releases. Now, here number of closed loop is 1, you got 1, so this is fixed, so it is 1 into 3 minus number of releases, here it is fixed, there is no release, it is not free to move in the vertical direction, not free to move in the horizontal direction, and also not free to rotate as far as A is concerned. Coming to support D is hinged, that means its position is fixed. Whereas, because it is a hinge, it is free to rotate. Therefore, the degree of freedom is, or number of releases is equal to 1 at C, namely the rotation. So, number of release equal to 1. That is, it is free to rotate at D, as at C being a hinge. Therefore, 1 into 3 minus 1 equal to 2. So, the degree of indeterminacy, the degree of static indeterminacy equal to 2 for this structure. So, we have to remove any two redundants, make the structure statically determinate. There are number of ways of making the structure statically determinate. You can introduce a hinge here, and we can remove any one component here. Maybe you can place it on rollers. When we remove a hinge, introduce a hinge here, it is free to rotate. So, rotation degree of freedom will be there. If we place it on rollers, it will be free to move in the horizon. So, we have to remove any two redundants. So, what we are going to do here is, here also, we can place this on rollers. So, when this is placed on rollers, it is free to move along the roller and also it is free to rotate. So, there itself, we can remove 2 degrees of redundancy. We can retain support C as it is. Any two redundants are to be removed. Now, what we are going to do here is, we are going to remove the support at C. So, support at C means, so when this is the support C, now as it is, there will be a vertical reaction, there will be a horizontal reaction. Horizontal reaction at C will be there, vertical reaction V at C will be there. Now, we will remove the support here, remove the support C here, introduce VC and HC as a redundant forces. So that now it is free, the structure is determinate, these are the two forces that are there at the point C, introduce those forces as redundants. Now this becomes a cantilever, determinate structure with the two forces HC and VC. Now it is our job to find out what is the value of HC, what is the value of VC. We are going to introduce the strain energy method and we are going to make use of the Castiglione's theorem 2. Now, we know the strain energy, if we just consider this predominantly subjected to bending moment. Therefore, U equal to integral m square dx divided by 2a as we have already discussed. This is the strain energy equation. Now at this point C, in the given structure, the horizontal displacement is equal to 0, vertical displacement is also equal to 0. According to Castiglione's first theorem, when the total strain energy is partially differentiated with respect to the vertical force, that will give you the vertical displacement. And here the vertical displacement delta at the point C in the vertical direction is equal to 0. Similarly, according to first theorem, dou U by dou HC, when the total strain energy is partially differentiated with respect to HC, horizontal component, according to first theorem, it should give the horizontal displacement, that is delta of the point C in the horizontal direction. Now, according to second theorem, not only according to the second theorem, in the given structure C is hinged, its position is fixed, it cannot undergo vertical or horizontal displacement. Therefore, dou U by delta C in the horizontal direction is also equal to 0. So, we are going to make use of this, namely this is dou U by this is dou U by dou VC, this is dou U by dou HC, that is partial derivative of the total strain energy with respect to vertical force, partial derivative of the total strain energy with respect to horizontal force. According to second theorem, this is 0, this is also 0. So this is what we are going to make use of in the problem, right? So here these are the equations, dou U by dou HC equal to 0. So U is integral m square dx divided by 2a. So this is the derivation, single line derivation only. So 1 by a we are taking outside, integral m into dou m by dou hc into dx equal to 0. Similarly, dou u by dou vc, 1 by a into m into dou m by dou vc in dx equal to 0. So this we have elaborately discussed already, therefore, right. Now coming to the moment of inertia, here in this problem, we cannot cancel this moment of inertia, we cannot take this 1 by a to right hand side and cancel, because here for the member AB, the moment of inertia is 2i, for the member BC, moment of inertia is I. So we have to substitute the appropriate value of I in this equation, therefore let us avoid taking this to the right hand side and cancelling. We will retain on the, so in the earlier problem, we have taken this to the right hand side and we have cancelled EI. Now we are not cancelling because I varies. Earlier problem, I was uniform. Now I varies. So this is another important point to be discussed. Right. Now, so we want the value of, we want M, we want dou M by dou with C, and of course I value. Here also, we want M, dou M by dou VC, because this is dou U by dou VC. So, dou M by dou VC and I value for this part. So, these are the three values that are required for calculating this. The thing is, we will have the equation for MX, equation for M, in terms of VC, in terms of, so that bending moment equation will be consisting of VC and HC, both will be there. So what we have done here is, for making the structure statically determinate, we have removed the support at C, removed the hinge here, and replaced the forces by VC in the vertical direction, HC in the horizontal. So the direction may be towards right or that is not a matter. We assume something. If our assumption is not correct, we will be getting with the negative sign. That is not a problem, because some of the viewers may be having a doubt. HC, how you have taken to the left, why not to the right? Yes, it can be. If it is to the right, you will be getting the value with a negative sign. So don't worry about the direction now. Right. So we want the values of I, Mx, dou m by dou hc, dou m by dou vc for calculating this. Since I varies, we are retaining 1 by a on the left hand side. We have not taken to the right hand side and cancelled as in the earlier problem. Earlier problem, it was uniform. Right. Now coming to this problem. Now, we are just dividing the frame into three sections. Actually, from C to D, this one section, because in between there is no other load. Then D to B, we have another section, and B to A, there is another section. So we just take three sections. All right. Now, three portions, CD, DB, and BA. DB and BA. Right. Now, next is, yes. Now, this is the table. This table, we write portion. Portion, origin, portion, origin, limits, limits, then we have mx or mxx or m, nothing, depending on any section, x. Then we want dou u by dou hc for one equation, dou u by dou hc for one equation, and dou m by dou hc we want, dou m by dou vc we want. Since I varies, a column for moment of inertia. Right. Now in our problem, we have take portions CD, portion DB, and a portion BA. That is CD, DB, and BA. Right. Now, for the portion CD, we have taken origin at C, limits 0 to 3 meters. So, here, next, of origin is C. The height is 3 meters, therefore 0 to 3, and coming to the bending moment, see here, so the bending moment here, there are two forces, namely one is VC, the other one is HC. VC, as far as member CD is concerned, VC is an axial force that will not cause any moment. So HC into X, horizontal force into vertical distance. So HC into X will be a clockwise moment. So to the right of the section. So we know right anti-clockwise is positive. So here HC into X is a clockwise moment. So right clockwise is negative. So HC into X, VC will not cause any moment. Therefore, minus HC into X. So that is the equation, HC into X. Right. Now, dou m by dou HC. dou m by dou hc equal to minus x. When this is partially differentiated with respect to hc, it is minus x. Dou m by dou vc. So this equation does not contain vc. Therefore, dou m by dou vc equal to 0. And for the member cd, moment of inertia is I only. Right. That is one equation. Right. Coming to the portion db, we have taken the origin at the point D. Therefore, the moment due to this force, VC will not cause any force. VC is an axial force, right? HC will cause a moment. We have taken the origin at the point D. Therefore, about the section XX, HC will cause a moment of HC into 3 plus X. HC will cause a clockwise moment. So, minus. Therefore, minus HC into 3 plus X. Then we have another value, HC into 3 plus X. Then 60 is there. So 60 into X, that is again clockwise. 60 into X is also clockwise. Right clockwise, negative. Therefore, 60 into X. Therefore, minus 60 into X. Therefore, these are the two forces. So to the right of X, one is HC into 3 plus X, then 60 into X, and VC is an axial. These are, we have considered all the forces to the right of the section. So that is, and here origin is D. Only from D we have taken X. So limits will be 0 to 3 meters, because origin is taken here, 0 to 3 meters. So here, origin is D, therefore limits are 0 to 3 meters. So that is the equation, right? Now from this equation, we find dou m by dou hc is minus of 3 plus x. When this is differentiated partially with respect to h, it is minus of 3 plus x. Right. Dou m by dou vc. So this does not contain vc term. Therefore, this is 0. And for this, moment of inertia is I only. So that is the second equation. Coming to bc. X is measured from B. So origin is B. Limits are 0 to 4 meters. Because the length of member AB is 4 meters as per the previous diagram. That is not marked here. So this value is 4 meters. So limits 0 to 4 meters. Origin is B. So here origin is B. Limits 0 to 4 meters. Coming to the moment, HC, horizontal force into vertical distance. Vertical distance is 6 meters. HC into 6. HC into X is clockwise. HC into 6 is clockwise. So, right clockwise is negative. Therefore, minus HC into 6. Then, VC into X. Vertical force into horizontal distance. We are taking moment about this section. So VC into X. VC is a vertical force. VC into X is anticlockwise. Right anticlockwise is positive. Therefore, plus VC into X. Then we have 60. 60 into 3 meters. We are taking moment in the member AB. So 3 meters. 60 into 3 is clockwise, so negative. So minus 60 into 3, right. Then we have UDL, 40 kilonewton per meter over a length equal to x meters. So 40 into x into x by 2 will cause a clockwise moment about the section xx. This 40 over the distance x, the load over the distance x will cause a clockwise moment about xx. So that is also negative, right? Clockwise is negative, right? Anticlockwise is only positive, clockwise is negative. Therefore, coming to this, so minus 40 into x by 2, 40 into x by 2. So that is the equation, or you can say this is 40, we can say 20x square by 2, 40x square by 2, 40x square by 2, or 20, or we can say 20x square, whatever form in which you want, we can just simplify and have it, right? Now, from this equation, dou m by dou hc, only this contains dou m hc term. Therefore, dou m by dou hc equal to minus 6. So, this is vc, it's a number, only one term contain hc. Therefore, dou m by dou hc equal to minus 6. Then, dou m by dou c we want, dou m by dou vc. So, dou m by dou vc, only this term contains vc. Other terms, they are not containing vc. So, dou m by dou vc equal to x. Dou m by dou vc equal to x. Minus 6 and x. And moment of inertia of the horizontal member is 2i. So, if these values are correctly written, other things only calculations. So, we have to be doubly careful about the sign, minus, plus, etc. So, that is a very important steps. Now, these values, now we want for the equations 1 and 2, for the equations 1 and 2, we want m, this already we have discussed, right? So, now, so we have mx, we have, so we are going to substitute these values. We are going to substitute this value, and also this value in equations 1 and 2, right. Now, let us take the first equation as dou u by dou hc, the partial derivative of the total strain energy, dou u by dou hc. Dou u by dou hc equal to, we know, it is 1 by ei for the first part. For the first part, it is 1 by ei into limits 0 to 3, mx equal to minus hc into x, minus hc into x. This is mx. Then dou mx by dou hc, dou mx by dou hc equal to minus x, equal to minus x into dx. 1 by ei, mx, dou m by dou hc into dx. This is for one part. For the second part, limits are 0 to 3. So, equation is minus hc into 3 plus x minus 60x. So, this is one value. So, this is mx. Then, dou mx by dou hc. Dou mh by dou hc. Hc equal to minus of 3 plus x. Minus of 3 plus x. So, this minus I am taking to the beginning. So, we have to incorporate this minus somewhere into dx. So, that is for the second part. Third part, limits 1 by, this is 1, this is also 1 by a, this is 1 by a. Now, here 1 divided by 1 divided by e. So, here I for the member is 2i. This is very important. Number is 2i into limits are 0 to 4. So, 0 to 4 into minus 6hc plus vc into x minus 180 minus 20x square. This is mx. Then dou m by dou hc. So we are differentiating with respect to h. So dou m by dou hc equal to minus 6. Equal to minus 6 into dx. Now these things, according to equation 1, this must be equal to 0. Dou u by dou hc equal to 0. Equal to 0. So this simplification, I will just give only the final equation, because of course it consists of only x. That is, first we have to multiply these two, hc into x will give you plus hc x square, and hc x square on integration will give you hc into x cube by 3. And in that equation, we have to substitute the upper limit and the lower limit. One term. Second term, you have to multiply the whole thing by 3 plus x, you have to multiply everything, simplify. After simplification, integrate, x will become x square by 2, x square will become x cube by 3. So like that, we can just integrate, substitute the lower limit. Lower limit is 0, so that will give you another term. Similarly, third term. Therefore, this calculation, simply integrating x square, simplifying, substituting the upper and lower limits. So this will take a lot of time. Therefore, viewers, I think, can do this calculation. I'll just give the final equation, right? On doing this, we'll be getting an equation 144 hc minus 24 vc equal to minus 4790. So we will call this as equation A. That is one equation. So it will involve the calculation for another 3 steps or maximum 4 steps. Simplification, integration, substitution, right? And next is that of, this is with respect to hc, then dou u by dou vc. Dou u by dou vc, we know 1 by ei into integral 0 to l m, then dou m by dou vc dx. The algebraic sum for all the 3 members is equal to 0. Dou u by dou vc equal to 0, right? Now coming to this, for the first member, 1 by ei into, yes, next, yes, this is the tabulation. For the first member, 0 to 3, hc into x. So, 0 to 3, minus hc into x, minus hc into x. So this is mx. This is mx. Mx equal to minus hc into x. Now we want dou m by dou vc. Dou m by dou vc equal to 0 here. Therefore into 0 into dx plus. For the second term also, we have equation for mx by dou m by dou vc equal to 0. Therefore this, we need not unnecessarily waste our time in writing this, because this into this will become 0. Therefore, second term is also 0 plus third term 1 by e into 2i. This is very important, 2i, right? 2i into that equation, say this equation minus HC into 6 minus HC into 6 minus HC into 6 plus VC into X, VC into X minus 180 minus 180 minus 180, then say plus 20 X square, plus 20 X square. So plus 20 X square. So this is MX, this is MX into dou MX by dou VC, dou MX by dou VC equal to X, equal to X. So into X into DX equal to 0. Limits will be 0 to 4 meters, 0 to 4 meters, right. So 0 to 4 meters. Therefore, this need not be done. This is already 0. So this is the only term we have to, that is multiply by this by X actually, 1 by 2 EI into 0 to 4, this will be minus HC into 6X plus VC into X square minus 180 into X plus 20 into X cube into DX equal to 0, equal to 0. So this we can integrate first, X will become X square by 2, X square will become X cube by 3, X will become X square by 2, X cube will become X to the power 4 by 4. That we can do it easily, do it. And then we substitute the upper limit 4, lower limit is 0, no problem. Therefore, substitute the upper limit and the lower limit, multiply by 1 by 2 EI, 1 by 2 EI. And finally, we will get one equation. When dou u by dou vc equal to 0, we will give you the equation minus 24 hc minus 24 hc plus 10.65 vc equal to 1360. So this is equation B. We call this equation B. So the calculation part of this simple calculation, I leave it to the viewers. You can just do it and we will get these equations. Now solving we will get HC equal to minus 19.18 kilonewton. So that means the direction assumed by us is not correct, it is to the right. Anyway, that will always lead to the correct answer. So VC equal to 84.46 kilonewton. So these are the redundant forces, these are the redundant forces at the point C. So this is how we have to make use of the Castigliano's second theorem for getting the redundancy. Now we have to substitute these values because we got the equation, namely for the portion CD we know the equation for MX equal to minus HC into X. Therefore for the portion CD MX equal to minus HC into X. So this is as per this minus HC into X. So now this equation we are going to use for substituting different values of X and getting the value. So it varies from 0 to 3 meters CD. It's only CD. So now when X equal to 0, X equal to 0, MC equal to 0. It is a hinge, right? Then when XE equal to 3 meters, MD equal to minus HC is minus 19.18. Therefore, minus 19.18. So, minus 19.18 into 3. So, equal to minus or minus plus 19 into 3. So, this will be 57.54 kilonewton meter. So, similarly, the equation for dB. Equation for dB will be minus HC into 3 plus X minus 60X. Therefore, minus HC into 3 plus X minus 60 into X. So, this is MX. Now, here dB 3 meters, dB again is 3 meters. Therefore, and here X is taken, so here you will have to be very careful where we have taken the origin. So, here for the member BC, for the portion dB, origin is taken at D. Therefore, limits are 0 to 3 meters only. So, 0 means we are at the point D. 3 means we are at the point B. So, this is a very important point, right? Therefore, we will substitute 0 and 3 meters because we have taken origin at D. Therefore, when X equal to 0, and MD will be minus HC, minus of HC itself is minus 19.18 into 3 plus 0 minus 0 because X is 0, therefore minus 0. So, this is again minus plus 19.18 into 3 equal to 57.54 kilonewton meter. In X equal to, that is the same value as that of this, right? Then when X equal to 3 meters, MB equal to minus 19.18 into 3 plus 3 minus 60 into 3. So, on substitution, this will be minus 64.92 equal to minus 64.92 kilonewton meter, right. Then for the portion BA, so I will just directly give the value. Now we have to take this equation. In this equation, we have to substitute 0 and 4. For getting the value at B, we have to substitute because we know origin is taken at the point B. So, for B, X is 0. For A, X is 4 meters. So, in that equation, namely in this equation, substitute X equal to 0 and X equal to 4, MB equal to minus 64.92 kilonewton meter when you substitute X equal to 0. And this will be containing the term V also. This will be containing this problem. Yes, this contains both HC as well as VC. Both you'll have to substitute here. Both values you'll have to substitute. So, because we know the values. We know HC as well as VC. this also will have to be substituted. So substituting, and then x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 4 meters will give you the final values. So MA equal to minus 47.08 kilonewton meter. So this will be the values of the moments. Right. Now here the sign convention to be followed here is, if they are beams, tension at top if negative. So the sign convention we have followed earlier only, a tension at the bottom if positive. Similarly, for the columns, so this is the sign convention for plotting the bending moment diagram. So if tension is outside, if negative. So and the tension is inside means, or tension if it is inside, it will be positive, if positive. So this is applicable only for single bay frame. So tension outside means negative, or if the value is negative, tension is outside. If the value is positive, tension is on the inside. This is for a single bay frame. So this is outside, this is inside. So this is top, this is bottom. So if it is negative, tension at the top. If it is positive, tension at the bottom, right. So this is then next is that of the bending moment diagram. It will be, this is the frame. Now, here, this is A, B, D, this point is D, here this is C, this is the frame, right. Now, what is the value of MA? MA is minus 47.08. So, MA is minus 47 means, as far as the beam is concerned, if it is negative, tension at the top. So we have to plot the value on the top. So this is 47.08. Kilonewton meter. Right. Now, tension next for B. For B also, it is minus 64.92. Therefore, it is also on the top. So, 64.92 kilonewton meter. This is the support moment diagram, right. Now coming to the column, now at C it is 0, MC is 0, MD is 57.54, 57.94. Now 57.94 is plus, so as far as the frame is concerned, if tension is on the inside, it will be plus. If it is plus, see here, we can see, if it is plus, tension is on the inside. One more point, this will directly give the net positive value. Net. So this is a very important point to be noted. So here, in the frame, here 57.94 is this value. 57.54 is plus. So this value is 57.54 kilonewton meter. 57. So this is 64.92 outside. 64.92 outside, because it is negative. And here this will be giving you the net value here. This is the net value here. So net value is given here. Therefore, the bending moment diagram will be, if it is plotted on the tension side, we are plotting the bending moment on the tension side. Right. Now here again it will vary from plus 57.54, plus means tension on the inside, and it is 0, where x equal to 0, md equal to 57.94, and x equal to 3 meters. So this is cd, this is for cd. Cd is 0, d is 57. Actually what we have plotted is this 0 and 57.54. What we have plotted is 0 and 57.54. This we have plotted. So next calculation is, so for DB, at D it is 57.54, at B it is minus 64.92. So this is how we have to plot the diagram. So this bending moment values, we have to substitute. Suppose we take the next page. Now we can find out MA and MB. In between, for x equal to 2 meters, x equal to 2 meters, if you calculate, we will be getting the net value here. Net value will be getting 24. Net value will be getting at the midpoint of AB, will be getting 24. If that is also plotted on the tension side, because one way is drawing the support moment diagram and superimposing the simply support moment diagram. Now this calculation gives you straight away the net value. Actually, if simply support beam is calculated, moment is calculated as W L square by 8. W is 40 kilonewton per meter, L is 4 square by 8. So that will give you 40, this will give you 5. So 5 into 16 equal to 80 kilonewton meter will be the positive bending moment. So that is the total ordinate here will be 80. So this calculation will straight away give you the net positive value and net negative value. Therefore, when the bending moment diagram, instead of plotting like this, if it is plotted on the tension side, because we know it will be on the bottom, of course it is not proportionate. Well, so this net value is given by this calculation. So this net value will be a 24. This is what is given by the calculation by strain energy method. Actually, we have to find out the ordinate at the center will be 47.08 plus 64.92 by 2. That will be the average ordinate. So that ordinate plus 24, that will be, I think 80, 24 means 56. So this value will be 56. This value will be 56. But this will give only the net value. When 56 and 24 are added, we will be getting this value. Therefore, at different sections, we can find out the value. Straight away, that will give the net value. Net value. So here also, in this case also, so for CD, there is a lateral load of 60 kilonewton. L is 6 meters. L is 6 meters. So WL by 4 is a simply support moment diagram. WL by 4 equal to, so this will be 15. 15 into 6 equal to 90 kilonewton meter. 90 kilonewton meter is the simply supported bending moment diagram. But we are getting only 57.54. Reason is, if this is added, if we draw a line like this, now this total value up to this will be 90, will be 90. Now, this is what is the simply support moment diagram. Now, the ordinate at the mid height will be 64.92 by 2 equal to 32.46. Now, when 32.46 and 57.54 are added, we'll get 90. So what I want to say here is, if you calculate 90 and 80, so that is the total ordinate. The total ordinate at the center is 90. The total ordinate at the midpoint is 80. Whereas the strain energy calculation will give the net positive value here and the net value here. It will not give the total value. So if one wants to verify, we can do the calculation like this. That is, WL by 4 is 90. So 90 minus, you subtract this, you will get this value. Similarly, total is 80 minus 24 will be the net value. So this value will be, the 56 will be the average of this and this. So this 56 plus 24 you will be getting here. Whereas the strain energy method will give you the net positive value and the net positive value here. So need not, therefore, this line is not necessary. Anyway, only for completion to understand the concept. Therefore, the bending moment diagram for this frame will be, so the negative value and this thing. And this is parabolic. So net ordinate, you can just mark as per the calculation. Here negative ordinate, here it is positive, and here it is zero. So the calculation will give you this value, and also this value will be straight away given. If you want to verify, you can complete this line and do the calculation and check it. Similarly, if you want to find out the calculation here, you can find out this and add this, you will be getting this value. So I think you have to read once more, and you will understand. So this is the bending moment diagram, because certain things need to be discussed elaborately, so that there will not be any confusion at a later stage. Therefore, that is about the bending moment diagram. So that completes analysis of a frame by strain energy method. Right? Thank you. We'll meet in the next lecture. Thank you.